Konnichiwa, motherfuckers! Yeah! Guess who's back in the house with three super golden cocks for your mouth? Sexual stories, bitches! It's fucking back! The three kings have returned! The fucking Star of David is in the sky! And everyone can see fine and healthy and fucking fantastic. What's up, bitches?
What's up, ladies and genitals? It is your boy, 6 pounds, Dildo Space Booth, bringing back the circle jerk of awesomeness.
Asshole.
Let's do this shit!
Yeah, that's Simple Minds, motherfuckers. A silverback from God knows where. All right, bitches. You guys, I mean, maybe you guys don't know what's going on, but Sexual Stories was perhaps the most popular fucking series on YouTube as far as view to sub ratio. Am I not right with that, brothers and sisters?
Oh, it's very true.
Very true.
I concur.
Excellent. Thank you, Dr. Floppy. And, oh, fuck, here we go again.
Alrighty, bring it back. All right.
Kicking it old school. All right, motherfuckers. So basically, we talk about stories of past experiences of us putting our penis inside of vaginas. And, yeah, I'm going to stop with the bullshit. And the circle jerk of awesomeness is ending. And I'm going to fucking tell my story. You guys ready? I'm fucking ready. Let's do this. All right. Okay, before I even begin, I'm under the premise that, like, you know, when we go out to bars and you go to clubs or whatnot, you try to pick up, you know, the good-looking girls, hopefully. And, you know,
or men,
yeah, depending upon your sexual orientation. John, I mean, I guess, I don't know, John, you like men apparently now?
I'm just saying, you know, yeah, we do true. Have an audience.
That is true. We do have a large audience. There may be some gay individual out there, and we're not one to judge. So if you enjoy putting your penis in the anus of a young man, by all means, go for it. But, yeah, like, so I'm going to, my personal mantra is if I go and I can't get any good looking girls, at least at the end of the night, I'm going to try to take home a fat chick. Because in my opinion, fucking a fat girl at the end of the night is better than fucking your own hand. I don't know. What do you think?
I've never harpooned a whale, but I don't know, man. I've never really boned a fat chick. So I would have to say I probably enjoy my hand rather than a large woman.
Well, okay, fuck.
I'm going to one-up both of you. I'd rather stick my penis in a fucking fifi.
What the fuck's a fifi?
It's a homemade pocket pussy. We can talk about that some other time.
Okay, I'll get on my story. Okay, I'll have a story. Okay, that's what I feel. So this is why this story is a silky smooth segue from my intro there into my story now. So anyways, I'm at the bar, you know, get my motherfucking mojo on, hanging out, trying to pick up broads and shit. This wasn't working out for the cock and gold. I don't know, dudes were cock blocking, hating on me, whatever it is. Perhaps the club changed its kind of profile and it fucked with my sub count. I don't know. But so I'm in the bar, I'm trying to get my mojo. Shit wasn't working, you know, I'm drunk. And then a night rolls around and all there is like, you know, a couple fat chicks. They're not like beastosauruses or nothing. You know, they're just big girls. And I'm thinking like, well, fuck it. I start chatting her up. And next, you know, we're heading back to her place. And we're at her place and, you know, things are going on. I'm thinking like, you know what, fuck it. I'm horny. I'm drunk. I'm just going to bang this bitch. So we're, you know, we eventually get off of the bedroom. We start the old fucking going on here. And the problem is I hadn't been drinking enough like prior to leaving the club. So I start sobering up, you know, midway going into this girl and I'm banging her. It's like fat chick from behind. And I start to go soft because I'm actually getting turned off and I can't keep the fucking hard on. And so because like I'm fucking like, you know, when you're drunk, you know, you're the fucking dick looks good. Or pussy looks good, you know, fucking with like
scab.
Whatever, I guess I'm gay. Good. Well, I got a story about being gay later on in future episodes. We'll get into that another time. But whatever, the pussy looks good, even though it's from a fat chick when you're drunk. And I start, you know, I got beer goggles on. So then I start sobering up. And she's like, what's going on? You okay? And I'm like, don't want to fucking tell her, well, no, I'm sorry, you're fat and ugly. And I, you know, I'm just losing my erection. So I'm like, oh, yeah, I think I drank too much. I don't feel good. So I'm pretending to be sick so I don't, like, embarrass her and, like, make myself look like an ass. So I'm like, oh, I don't feel good. She's like, well, why don't you go to the washroom and wash up or whatever? You know, I'm like, all right. So I go in the bathroom. I'm like, staring at myself in the mirror. I'm like, come on, I thought, smack myself. You can fucking do it. Get a hard on. Come on. I'm sitting there rubbing my cock in the bathroom, trying to get an erection. Like, Come on, motherfucker, you can do it. And I'm like, dude, I'm fucking trying to pump myself up. Like, come on, motherfucker. Like, you know, I go out there and I start kissing and stuff again. And she's like, you okay? And I start getting hard a little bit. And, you know, I slide in there, fucking get so wet. And I start fucking, I lose my hard on and same fucking thing over again. I'm like, you okay? I'm like, yeah, I don't feel too good. I go to the bathroom. Go back in the bathroom again. I'm like, come on, motherfucker. Spat myself in the face again. Like, come on, look at myself in the mirror and get fucking turned on. Oh, God, sexy nipples. And it fucking... I went out there, man. I tried, dude. And, like, you ever had those orgasms with, like, half an erection because you fucking force it so hard? Like, you just,
yeah.
You clench your butt cheeks and shit and tighten up your fucking prostate so much that you have no choice but to bust a nut. So I went out there fucking, like, probably overall the fucking experience was 30 minutes, but the actual, like, hard pumping was, like, 5 minutes because I just kept losing erection back and forth, pretending like I was sick. fucking came at half erection inside her and just said, like, okay, I gotta go, I don't feel good, and bounced the fuck out, and that was it.
You know what you should do next time? If you're hitting it from the backside and you're telling her you feel sick, she can't see you, so just fucking gag yourself and puke on her back and tell her you're out. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, God.
Yeah, that's a little fucking, that's a little over the top, Jed. I don't know, well, man.
There's no such thing as over the top, brother.
I think I did well. I pumped myself up, I busted a nut, and I finished it off and went home.
I think when you put the pussy on the pedestal, Ben, that's when you start going soft, man. You can't put that much thought into it, man. It's a fat chick. Come on, man.
Yeah, I know, but I sobered up, and I just couldn't keep the erection, and I just fucking I didn't want to quit. I wanted to fucking like finish it off. I didn't want to be like one of those guys who lost his erection during sex. I didn't want to be that kind of dude, so I just fucking forced it.
Nice.
That's it. That's my story. There you go. Fat chicks, maybe not better than the hand in retrospect.
All right. Well, I'll get into a quick story here. This is when I was a junior in high school. And there's a girl in my criminal justice class. She was a senior, and her name was Kelly. I'll actually use her real name because I don't give a flying fuck. And
What's her last name, Jeff?
I'm not telling that part.
Oh, okay. All right. So you give a little fuck.
Yeah, I give a little
Kelly Kapowski.
Fuck. Yeah, Kelly Kapowski. Saved by the Bell. So anyways, like...
you're built like A.C. Slater.
I remember like hearing her in class one time. This girl, when I say she's husky, she's not a big girl. She's actually kind of skinny, but she had a husky voice, like one of those smoker's voices. And I'll never forget her talking. I heard her talking to some dudes one day, and she was talking about, all I heard how to come out of her mouth was, I suck dick. And I was just like, oh, shit. I'm like, this girl's a fucking slut. Maybe I ought to start flirting with her a little bit. Maybe I'll get some. So I fucking, you know, was flirting with her for a couple weeks. It took a little bit of work in class. You know, I just kind of played it cool, like I wasn't really into her, but just fucking around with her and stuff. So we were at a party one week. It was probably about a month down the road, and I could tell, you know, she was kind of liking me and stuff. I was like, yeah, fuck yeah, I'm going to get this girl to suck my dick, as she would say. So we go in this back room, this party, and we start making out and shit. So I was like, man, hell yeah, dude, I'm going to do what I do best. So I'm going to go down here and munch on this bearded clam for a little bit.
Oh, God, here we're already. Oh, yeah. He brought it back, the fucking phrases. Oh, yeah.
The fucking Jeff phrases.
So I'm doing like the romantic shit. You know, I'm kissing her fucking titties, and I'm working my way down slowly from her titties down to her stomach. And then I start unbuttoning her pants, and I get down to her belly button, and I got her pants down. I'm like, fuck yeah, here it is. And I start kissing and kissing. I'm like, it's kind of fuzzy, a little too high. I'm like, what the fuck is going on here?
Oh, no.
The bitch had a happy trail.
Oh yeah.
I swear to God, dude, this girl had fucking hair starting at her belly button all the way down to her pussy. I mean, it was like a dude.
Awesome.
So the point of this story is when I went down there, and I fucking still went ahead and did it. I was just like, working, I was flossing my teeth with her hairs on the way down. I was like, God damn it, this is fucking bullshit. So I ended up fucking eating her ass. She ends up sucking my cock. We didn't fuck or anything. I was kind of turned off by this. But to this day, my friends were like, remember that chick you ate out with fucking Happy Trail? And like, they always, whenever they saw this chick, they would just call her Happy Trail. And it was a horrible experience. It's the only chick I've ever messed around with that much hair. I don't know. It could have been a dude with a sex change. But I don't think people get sex changed that early in life in high school. But
speaking of gay, like Jeff had sex with a transsexual. Was she from Thailand?
Her belly was like mine, but she had a little bit more brown sugar. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, Will Ferrell reference. All right, well, I guess I'm up. My story is going to be how I turned my wife into a fucking freak. So one night after I used to be a bouncer. One night I came home and my wife and I just started dating. And when I came to her apartment, she was just wearing these booty shorts and they were lace. And we started getting it on. And I got a little out of control. So I flipped her over. She's on her stomach now, and I get in a headlock, and I start pulling her hair back, and I start talking dirty to her. I'm like, yeah, you dirty fucking little slut. Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, how long have you known her for?
This was probably maybe a month into the relationship. Jesus, I just, John. Look, dude,
Tim
yeah.
Silver,
dude, dude, it was a little too soon. Too soon? But
too soon, yeah.
Anyway.
Just a little bit.
But anyway, she let me finish, and right when I finished, she started fighting me and pushing me off. She's like, how dare you? How dare you treat me like that? But you know what? Still, she was such a great lady. After that, every time I had sex, I enjoyed a nice glass of Nesquik chocolate milk. She still went downstairs and got me some fucking chocolate milk. I'm like, oh man, this is wifey right here. So 3 days later, we were making love.
Oh yeah. Bam, bam, bam. Sorry.
After we were making love, she's like, you know what? I kind of enjoyed it when you roughed me up and treated me like a dirty little slut. I'm like, really? She's like, yeah, just don't get too rough, but I enjoyed it. And ever since then, we couldn't make love anymore. We had to fuck. What's up?
Oh, did she have daddy issues by chance?
No, she didn't have daddy issues.
Did she hate her dad?
You're bringing up kind of a serious subject, but her she lost her dad at an early age, Ben.
Okay. Right. I knew something was up with her dad. Okay, but I'll talk about it another time. Sorry. That's great. Yeah. So we went from sexist stories to John's wife's. Oh fuck. She doesn't watch our commentaries, does she?
No, man. No, she's cool, man.
Okay. I feel really bad now.
Back.
What's that?
This is an epic return of sexual story.
No doubt, you insulted John's fucking wife's dead dad. That's great. Excellent. All right. Well, this has been sexual stories. Oh fuck! What else? Hey, reason why I said that is because I know, like, my friend. Ended on a high note. My friend.
Don't make a weird thing. Who cares? Don't make a weird, man. It's funny, man. It's good to go.
Okay, yeah. Okay, I'm going to talk. The reason why I asked about the daddy issues is because my friend's girlfriend is, like, she's, like, a really big slut. Like, fucking horrible. Like, she likes bukkake by multiple guys, and she's, like, a registered nurse. And if you saw her, she looks totally like a straight-laced normal broad. But she has serious daddy issues, and he was telling me, like, any girl with daddy issues is down for some crazy, sexy shit. They get weird. They have, like, things with their dad. And that's why I asked that question, and then apparently maybe true. I don't know.
All right. Yeah. So hi, I'm Simple Minds. Go fuck yourselves, YouTube. Stay classy.
XOXOXO.
And I made thoughts, and the moral of the story is try to find girls who have problems with their parents, and then you can fuck them like they're horrible little sluts that like to be pooped and peed on and like do a scat film. Signing out, 8 Thoughts, Cock and Goals. Oh, yeah.